Bob Alexander has accused me of, let me read this to make sure I get it right, illegally influencing government regulators on behalf of major campaign contributors, interfering with an ongoing Justice Department investigation, and violating federal election laws in the area of campaign finance. Okay, let's get right to the guts of it. Each one of these charges is absolutely true.
Die, you punk scum!
I'm the president, and as they say, the buck stops here. So I take full responsibility for every one of my illegal actions. But you see, that's not the whole story. And I think each one of you is entitled to the whole truth. I have here written proof in the form of notes, memoranda, and personal directives proving that Bob Alexander was also involved in each one of these incidents and in most cases planned them as well. Now, allegations of wrongdoing have also been made against Vice President Nance. Now, as this evidence will prove, at no time and in no way was the Vice President involved in any of this affair. Bob just made all that up. Vice President Nance is a good and decent public servant, and I'd like to apologize for any pain this may have caused him or his family. And while we're on the subject, I'd like to apologize to the American people. You see, I forgot that I was hired to do a job for you, and that was just a temp job at that. I forgot that I had 250 million people who were paying me to make their lives a little bit better, and I didn't live up to my part of the bargain. You see, I think there are certain things you should expect from your president. I ought to care more about you than I do about me. I ought to care more about what's right than I do about what's popular. I ought to be willing to give up this whole thing for something I believe in. Because if I'm not, If I'm not, then maybe I don't belong here in the first place.